Think about this. Aired in the summer of 2000, 17 years ago. And many of you have been watching with us from the start. You've never missed a season. You've never missed an episode. And now, a lot of you are watching with your kids, which is awesome. Because Survivor can play on so many levels. On one hand, you have this fantastic social, political game of human chess with strategy and deceit, but it can also inspire this.
Ladies and gentle cowboys, welcome back. My name is Peridiam, and let's talk about what we've already been talking about, the finale of Survivor, Heroes versus Healers versus Hustlers. What a crazy finale, right? Between the first vote with Mike and Devin's fantastic sideswipe that saved his life, to the upside-down you at the Immunity Challenge, are you kidding me? Ben finds another idol to save his butt, and then we get the new twist of the season at the Final Four Tribal Council, where we're canceling the vote and instead forcing a fire-making challenge. Chrissy gets this advantage of knowing this ahead of time, so we get this fun training montage of Devin sleeping on the beach. Damn it, Devin, what the hell was that? Yoga isn't going to start a fire.
This flint just broke because I'm not supposed to waste my energy. I need to go into this tribal council calm, cool, and I need to believe in myself because I do want the $1 million for my life, for my family's life, for everyone I care about. Tonight could change the rest of my life.
The fire-making challenge itself was a bit of a blowout and a little kind of anticlimactic, but hey, when you're up against a Marine, that's probably bound to happen anyway. And the final tribal council, to me, was pretty dang exciting, with another example of the open format that Survivor has switched to give an extra bit of life into that final chapter of the season. I actually don't mind this final tribal council format as much as I was thinking I might. The reunion was a bit of a wash. I'd say it was more of a coronation of Ben winning than actually getting to check back in with a lot of the other players, get their hot takes on the season and life after Survivor, but then I guess social media kind of fulfills that job now, doesn't it? But no, let's talk about this new twist. The twist that was heralded as the coming of a new age in Survivor, the Garbage. Okay, that was terrible, but thank you, Reddit, for that one. I chuckled.
You will choose one person to sit next to you at the final tribal council, forcing the two remaining players to earn their way to the end by battling it out in a fire-making challenge. The winner secures the final seat. The loser becomes the eighth member of the jury.
There's a lot to talk about in this video, but before I do, I want to ask you guys, what did you think about this new twist at the Final Four where we would go straight to a fire-making challenge, foregoing the vote and skipping the usual formalities? Did you like it? Dislike it? Were you not that bothered? Do you want to see it again, or maybe just keep it as a one-off or a two-off because it's actually in next season as well? I think voicing our opinions is important because I do believe that SEG, CBS, and the producers are listening to us, and the show can be affected by our words as dedicated fans. I think there's a lot to be said about this twist, so real talk, let's just get into it. I'll be talking about my opinion on the twist, the pros, the cons, but ultimately, how do we fix this, or do we even need to? So here's my take, and it's a long one, so just strap in and get ready. I think this new twist is one of the most dramatic twists the show has ever implemented in 35 seasons. And I think it's most comparable to introducing the final three in Survivor Cook Islands instead of having the usual final two. For the first 12 seasons, Survivor was all about getting down to the final two remaining castaways who would then battle head to head, but the switch to a final three changed that final chapter up quite a bit.
You must then follow the map to your final immunity challenge.
Wow, guys!
Final immunity challenge?
We got tree mail, and we were told that we're going to our final immunity challenge, which kind of blew our minds because we have one challenge left and we have four people. So we don't know what exactly that means, but I'm sure it's going to be a doozy.
As a result, the strategy of getting to the final tribal council also shifted quite dramatically, resulting in larger alliances feeling safer, knowing more of their occupants would still get a fair shake in front of the jury. This also meant you could take more of these less desirables, or goats, to the end of the game knowing there was enough room in the slaughterhouse for all of them. This new fire-making twist at the Final Four is essentially doing what the inclusion of the Final Three has done. It's an attempt for the game of Survivor to both kinda have its cake and eat it too. The producers, the fans, we all want the most compelling, most favorable castaways to win the game, however you define that. So when we had a string of third place finishers being just shy of the final tribal council, knowing they would win if they were given the opportunity to be there, the final three was born. However, with every cause, there's an effect. Every new twist will alter the game moving forward in some way, be it minor or major. In the case of the final three, it was major. The strategy for the old final three vote would now happen at the final four, which means a lot of the biggest, most strategic, most quote-unquote worthy players were cut at 4 instead of 3. Basically, the final 4 became the new final 3. Like I said, in an attempt to have the cake and eat it too, the producers didn't actually change much of anything with that twist. They simply pushed back the strategy to accommodate for more 0 vote getters. So I think you kind of know where I'm going with this. The new fire making challenge, assuming it becomes a staple in the game from here on out, will in effect push the final 4 vote to the final 5. Final 5 vote is going to go to the final 6, etc, etc. Knowing that the majority alliance doesn't have the power to remove its opposition at the final 4 anymore will now mean we'll see some of the biggest names being voted out at the final 5, because that's the last time they can be voted out, where everyone in the majority can actually do something about it with their vote.
So close.
Please bring me your torch.
So you did awesome, Dave.
Oh, hey, great game, guys. Great
game. I love
the name. Oh, that hurt.
David, tribe spoke.
Playing Survivor is the biggest dream I've ever had, and I'm so grateful I got to play it with all of you. Vanaka.
The problem I have here is that what I just described is Survivor in a nutshell, in a cake, any way you cut it, and the forced fire-making Final Four eliminates the core social aspect that has made the show kind of pretty compelling in the first place. It's all about the vote. To relay it to a theme, the blue-collar physical work is important to the show, but you also need the white-collar social strategies to succeed as well. Outwit, outplay, and outlast are the core tenets of Survivor, and I think Probst and the producers are tapping into that now more than ever. But what the Final Four twist this season has done is removed the outwit in favor of a new system that feels entirely incomplete. In essence, they are attempting to change something that doesn't really need to be changed. To bring this back to the season before HHH, the rehaul of the Final Tribal Council and Survivor Game Changers was indeed a pretty big game changer. And while it did also spark some debate, I think it did no harm to the structure of that part of the game. In fact, I think so far it's improved upon the tried and tested format of letting the jurors finally engage with the finalists, having the finalists' past come back to reap what they've sown. Alongside the final vote of each tribal, the jury twist is fundamentally fantastic, and the new format only makes it even more social and less rigid than ever before. And really, I think that goes hand in hand with what Survivor wants to see happen. The fire-making twist attempts to make the final 4 vote more exciting by forcing every vote from here on out to be a 2-2 tie no matter what, instead of the more likely 3-1 vote we often see. Unlike the change to the final Tribal Council performance in season 34 that I think improved upon the formula, I believe this twist, the fire-making challenge twist, fundamentally removes a part of Survivor, similar to Redemption Island, that really only ever worked before it was implemented. As far as Redemption Island goes, it drastically removed the gut punch of every vote in replacement for this lesser buff burn the day after, and it made for much less compelling television, despite on paper seeming like it could be leading to a lot of drama. But it turned the perfect formula of what makes Survivor so great upside down, and in this case there was no lid on that cup, which meant all of the contents inside just spilled everywhere and oh great, now we've got a big mess on our hands. All of this is to say, I don't think the forced fire-making challenge is an improvement the show needs or a twist the fans want. I also believe this twist is much more game-changing than the producers are perhaps willing to entertain. And if it's going to be implemented, it needs to be known from the get-go at the start of the season and not at the 11th hour in the form of a secret advantage that actually is anything but to the person who wins it. It's awkward TV and poor storytelling to see a player win the final immunity, win this final advantage, only to find out it's perhaps going to tank their game instead of helping them.
How fun is this twist going to be on a scale of 1 to 10, Chrissy?
0.
What is it?
Devin and Ben are going to have a fire making.
Why?
It's been difficult to wave off the unfortunate effect this new twist had on Devin's game, given that the usual rules, he would most likely be winning this season instead of being in the exact same placement this twist intended to prevent. But if the producers are hellbent on keeping this twist in the game, I think the best thing they can do now is make it a known element that will always exist at the final 4 from here on out, which I think might be tricky given potential medevacs or quits possibly messing up the schedule and forcing the final 2 on us, which would not be so bad actually. I do know that next season each of the new players will know about this twist at the start of the game and not at the 11th hour, which is better. Still though, I can't help but agree with a lot of the fans out there voicing their concern. If we're going to push the game back even more, then I suppose it's worth thinking about moving the last time you can play idols from the final 5 to the final 6, making it so there's still a window to prevent players from just idling themselves all the way to the end exactly like Ben again. Although I think that's not the best solution and is instead more just a symptom of what happens when you push the game back further and further, eventually it will break. It's nice that there is still a social element to the twist. They haven't just done away with it completely. Chrissy did get to grant immunity to Ryan, but it does also kind of feel like we're basically kind of watching Big Brother at the Final Four, where you have an HOH with their nominees. Although at least on Big Brother, they still have a vote. No fires there, probably for the best. Wouldn't want to burn any meatballs. It's a weird moment where in a previous video, I mentioned how implementing fire making challenges could be a solution to some awkward rules in the show. I'll just say that I think the rules on how to handle a no votes, final six, or revote may need some looking at. Maybe just throw a fire making challenge in there. I swear, everything can be made better with a fire making challenge. Yet, here we are with just that, and I feel like it's not worked. While fire is key to the show, as it represents your life in the game, I think what's most important to understand is that fire only represents your life, it has never actually been your life. The real life of Survivor is the vote. It's the final say from the first vote cast in the premiere, all the way to the final juror.
This has absolutely nothing to do with this. It sounds like sheer stupidity to me when somebody says, oh no, I'm not going to build an alliance, and I hope they wouldn't do that either. I giggle and think, okay.
God, I'm glad I'm on your team.
Yeah, baby.
You didn't come here to...
Yeah.
Make friends.
Even if the final four vote is not always the most dramatic, there are still big moves to be had in these subtler moments too. Perhaps this twist can produce similar moments, but it feels off, and not in a trying on a new pair of shoes kind of way. More like the shoe size is wrong, and I'd really just like a refund for the size that fits. And just for the record, I like Ben. He's a fantastic character and a pretty good game player. But I also can't predict what this twist changes had, say, Ben won the final immunity anyway, and then gone on to win the season. It feels kind of like this twist is just another twist designed to help the Day 38 boot, whomever they may be. I think it's par for the course as far as new twists over the past several seasons have gone, but I also think it's more affecting to the formula of the show in so much that it needs to be talked about before the expiration date on the refund policy kicks in and suddenly the show goes from sprinting in the ratings to sadly hobbling downhill as fans begin to tune out. Or maybe not. Maybe it'll work out and we're all just making a bigger deal than it really is. What do you guys think? Is this another Redemption Island twist? Do you think it can be improved upon next season and going forward? Were you happy to see Ben win? Let me know in the comments down below. Please subscribe for all the Survivor goodness. As always, my name is Peridiam and I will see you guys in the next video, assuming I don't get forced into a fire making challenge, because seriously, F that.
Will these new players learn from the mistakes of others?
It's the stupidest move you could ever make in the game. I'm not gonna make that mistake.
Or will the past come back to haunt again?
You have got to listen to your gut even more this season than ever before.
Join us this spring for Survivor Ghost Island.